Welcome to This Week in Astronomy, brought to you by Celestron, the world's leading manufacturer of telescopes. I'm Dave Eicher, editor of Astronomy magazine, and you know, the Milky Way is up there and it's rising late in the evening sky this time of year. Those galaxies in the so-called realm of the galaxies are starting to slip away in the evening, and we've got those really bright deep sky objects coming up in Scorpius, Sagittarius, Centaurus, all those really bright southern areas of the Milky Way as we see it, more or less toward the center of our galaxy. There are many, many objects of interest, of note here, but one of them that's really cool, I always like to look at this time of year, is a globular star cluster M22. And you can find it relatively near the so-called lid of the teapot shape of Sagittarius. That's Lambda Sagittarii is the bright star that marks the top of the lid of the teapot, and it's just a short distance off to the left, M22 is, of that bright star. It's one of the best globular clusters in the sky. These are old, ancient, huge spheres of old stars, yellowish stars that formed a long time ago, before the disk of the galaxy accreted, in fact. So they're very ancient in their composition. And you can see a yellowish color, even in binoculars under a dark sky, certainly in a telescope. A telescope of 6 or 8 or 10 inches in a nice dark sky will resolve a cluster like this very nicely, and you'll see the brightest component stars. Not all of them. There may be something like 500,000 stars in this cluster, but you'll see some of the stars resolved. It's a beautiful sight under a dark sky. Head out there, find the Milky Way. You'll have to wait a little while for the Milky Way to rise enough now late evening, and see if you can find one of the best globular clusters in our sky from Earth, M22. I'll see you next time.